Hi people, welcome back to the SFORM channel and thanks for tuning in. This video will be entirely about the EQ6R Pro, which arrived at my doorstep this week. And one of the most important questions I have is, can I actually set up this equatorial mount without reading the instructions? So without further ado, let's get into the video. I have these rusty markers. And here I have another one. And here I have a third one. Where is it actually? It's in front. So I'm using these markers to know exactly where the north is, to put the mount into the north position without actually using a compass or anything. So that's really nice. So let's move on to the next part. Let's see if I can do that without reading the manual. I'm going to level the EQ6R Pro with some pretty advanced material. A leveler.
Okay.
I miss my AVX. I miss my AVX. I miss my AVX. Okay, that actually wasn't too bad. It's heavier, of course, than my Celestron Advanced VX mount. But for like 1 or 2 meters to carry it outside and set it up, it's feasible. It's even, I would say, a little bit portable. I'm going to put these two into position. So I'm pretty confident that the arrow here indicates my latitude position. So I will just use the right ascension knobs here to put my mount into the 52 degree position as I am in Utrecht, the Netherlands. Loosen it up a little bit. Something like that. So because I'm at 52 latitude and when I want to move around my right ascension knobs, then this thing, it will actually touch this leg here. So I'm not too thrilled about that actually. So I am confused about one thing and I will show you here. I use my leveler to really level my mount. So I hope you can see it, but here you can see here it is level. And also when I put it like this, maybe you can't really see it. And it's also, let's focus here, it's also pretty much level. So I'm quite confident. I use this leveler for quite some time now and I never had problems with leveling my mount. But here you can see the bubble leveler. You can see that it is off. It points a little bit towards the left, the bottom left in this case. And when we focus on the leveler, completely level. So we got the SkyWatcher EQ6R Pro to work. And Emily will do the honors. Okay, let's try to press some buttons. Yep, moving.
Heel goed. So it's very quiet. That's nice. And what I also liked was the connection here. Dus Emily, heb je hem goed gekeurd? Doet hij het?
Ja.
Duimpje omhoog. Okay. So I hope you can see this here. So this is the damage caused by my Celestron AVX on my dovetail for my APO telescope here, my refractor. And this is just because these bolts, they were with the Celestron AVX, they are here, and they are really just you fix them on the dovetail itself, and this causes this this like the pain to go off basically. But with the EQ6R Pro, the two bolts to connect your dovetail or your Los Mendy style plate, I guess, are here, and they are not sticking into the tail itself in any way. So anyway, I hope I make myself clear, but I really like that kind of thing. So hi folks, it's getting dark. My EQ6R Pro is set up, and I have to install the software now, so let's see how that goes. Maybe a quick overview. I just mounted my 80mm APO telescope surface scope, my guide scope, and my camera here to the EQ6R Pro, because I am really really familiar with this gear, so I at least know how to work with this. So I can fully concentrate on getting the software working for EQ6R Pro. And I guess I will be using EQ Mod for the first time. So let's see if I can get it to work. And also I would like to get it to work with Sequence Generator Pro. So I will check some videos of other astrophotography colleagues, and I will read the manuals, look at some fora, and see if I can get this thing to communicate with all the software that I'm using. So hi folks, it's the next day, and I tried to get the EQ6R Pro working until 4 a.m. And I thought until that time, I thought I had a software issue with the EQ Mod, or maybe an ESCOM driver or something. But as it turns out, I think I have a mechanical problem. Because I'm now only connected via the hand controller. And you can see when I press the hand controller up and down, you see the highest axis is like the RA, I think. It just moves, so that's perfectly fine. Nothing's wrong there. But when I'm trying to move it left and right, you can see that the lower axis, I think it's the deck, it doesn't move. So I can hear the motor sound. I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear the motor running. So the same thing to do would be, of course, to go back to the store where I bought it and just ask the guys that have a lot of experience to take a look at it. But I think it's a minor problem. I think it's just like maybe the worm of the deck motor is not really snug or fixed correctly. So maybe because this is an Astroform channel anyway, I will just open up the EQ6R Pro, but the only thing is I just arrived, so I have to think about what I'm going to do. I see the problem here. Let's first secure my... I will show you the problem. I already saw it. Okay, so what you can see is that the belt has been disconnected. So I think either this, or I think this is the motor, right? And then this is the worm that actually drives the mount. But when the belt is not like connected to the worm, then of course the mount will not turn. Hey, is that something that rhymes? Okay. And I think this was here, and I think this is just like a thing that you have to put in. There's a ring you have to put in front of the belt,
I would guess, to keep that belt in place. So I don't know how this happened, maybe during transportation, but it's actually quite obvious what's going wrong here.
So I have the ring here, and yeah, I think it should be securely fixed here. So I think it should be securely fixed or welded on the worm, because yeah, right now I cannot fix it. And what happens then if this ring is not in place? Then I can slew for a while, but you can see now that the rubber belt, it's coming forward, and I think eventually it will fall off. So now I have, you can see it here, and now I have to push it back in place. Hey, what's this?
A person also wants to become a mechanic, I think, this insect. Move. So yeah, you can see that I found the problem. So that's nice. I can show this video to the supplier.
So maybe I have one like temporary Dutch solution for the moment, so that I can maybe try it out at least tonight. That is this wonderful piece of plastic rubber. Maybe I can just put it here to keep the belt more or less like fixed. What do you think? Would it work? I don't know. I will try it. The EQ6R Pro with a secret plastic ingredient inside. Let's see what happens. It turns, but for how long? We'll see. So hi folks, yeah, my apologies for this video. I wanted to make this a very positive video about first light with the EQ6R Pro, but it has turned into a first fight with the EQ6R Pro. It turned out to be a mechanical problem, and yeah, I will just go back to the supplier. It's Robotics in The Hague. I bought this mount from a Dutch web shop, and they are not to blame whatsoever, because normally they have high quality astronomy gear, and yeah, this is just a mount. I think it comes from the Sinta factory, and they just sell it to me. So luckily Robotics is in The Hague, so I will consult with one of the persons there, with Rob. Rob, if you're watching, hi hi. And actually they sell high quality astronomy gear, and he was very quick to respond once I reported this issue. So I'm fairly confident that we either I might get a new mount, or yeah, we might find a solution. Maybe they can repair it themselves. Anyway, thanks for watching. I thought I will post it anyway, because it's maybe useful for those of you who are dealing with nou ja, similar issues. So perhaps you would also then have a mechanical problem, and I showed you the motor drive at least, and the worm and the belt, so you could see that. And yeah, hopefully this video was useful. If it was, please give it a thumbs up, this problem video. Or maybe give it a thumbs down because of the Sinta problem. I don't know. And yeah, see you again in one of my other videos. Clear skies.